Dear participants, welcome once again to the topic of kitchen stewarding. Today what we are going to cover or talk about would be kitchen stewarding importance and records and the various records that is being maintained by the kitchen stewarding department. This is a part of the kitchen stewarding department syllabus. Myself Amit Gupta, I am assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality with the Chitkara University. So let's move forward. Today going to cover would be importance of the kitchen stewarding departments. We'll talk of opportunities in the kitchen stewarding department. We'll talk about different types of dishwashers that is used in the kitchen stewarding department, and we'll talk about different records maintained at the kitchen stewarding department. This is what the agenda for today's session is. Let me again repeat what we are going to cover today in the kitchen stewarding department part. We are going to talk about importance of the kitchen stewarding. We are going to talk about opportunities of the kitchen stewarding department. We are going to talk about different types of dishwashers used in the kitchen stewarding department, and we'll talk about different records maintained at the kitchen stewarding department by the kitchen stewarding persons. So let's move forward. The first thing that we are going to talk about would be the importance of the kitchen stewarding department. The first one it talks about is the kitchen stewarding department washes all kitchen pots and pans, that is cutlery and pot wash, in the back area. It maintains all the kitchen equipments so that it is in a functional state which could be used in the right manner. It cleans all the kitchen equipment and ensure hygiene, which is of utmost importance nowadays because of the COVID also. Prior to that also, hygiene was of prime importance. Different types of garbage disposable are being looked after by the kitchen stewarding department only. Now the kitchen stewarding department also cleans all the equipments which is used in the banquets. Generally, it is done in the back area of the main kitchen, or a satellite kitchen area is being created where dishwashers are being looked after, for especially dedicated towards the banquet in case the banquet operation is of a larger form. Now the next important talks about it polishes all the silverware, all the EPNS that is being used in the restaurants are being polished by the kitchen stewarding department. So there is a separate room where this EPNS buffing polishing takes place. Now any silverware which is damaged and required to be pre-plated, that is EPNS that need to be pre-plated with the silver coating, that is being looked after by the kitchen stewarding department. All the pest work, the pest control activities are being handled by the kitchen stewarding department. It carries all the transport, carries all the goods from the receiving department and transport it to the stores or to the kitchen. All the heavy equipments are being cleaned by the kitchen stewarding department. Intending for new crockery and cutlery is being looked after by the kitchen stewarding department, because in the last class also we have talked and said that the kitchen, all the equipments and the service, all the equipments are under the jurisdiction of the kitchen stewarding department, which is given on a loan basis to the departments for the smooth functioning. Now the next important is that all the gas connection of the tandoor or the gas connection of all the ranges of the kitchen is being handled by the kitchen stewarding department. It maintains the PPM level for sanitizing knives and chopping boards so that it is hygienic and it does not have any bacteria. In case any service ware need to be replenished, it is being handled by the kitchen stewarding department. Now we all know it is a very important department. So this department, either if it is a very big in nature, it reports directly to the general manager of the hotel, or it reports to the exec of the property or the establishment. Now when we talk about opportunities of a kitchen stewarding department, let's talk about the responsibility of the kitchen stewarding manager. The first prime role of the kitchen stewarding manager is to recruit, it means to hire new people, in coordination with the HR department, and train the staff members so that they can understand what is being required by them in the kitchen stewarding department. The kitchen stewarding manager prepares all the duty roster so that the back area and the necessary work that need to be performed, people are being manned for that. It periodically they supervise all the day-to-day work of the kitchen stewarding department. It ensure the continuous supply of the well-maintained clean and polished pans and pots, large cooking vessels and service equipment for production and service department. These are few of the opportunities. Rest of the opportunities are to maintain the hygiene standard of the establishment, keep washing area and staff cafeteria neat and tidy. We all know that the staff member, those who are working in the establishment, their meal are being looked after in the cafeteria. So cafeteria upkeep and cleaning of the back area, or we can say dishwasher area, all the utensils is being handled by the kitchen stewarding partner. Now all the filter that is in the that is used in the exhaust are being cleaned periodically by the kitchen stewarding department. Now EPNS cutlery need to be polished, plating need to be done, and it's required to be maintained. That is being handled by the kitchen stewarding department. Anything that is required maintenance is being looked after by the kitchen stewarding, and controlling the movement of stock of all food production and service equipments are being handled by the kitchen. Suppose I working in the service and I need 100 AP spoons, so I have to put a requisition for that to the kitchen stewarding department, and that department will give us the 100 AP spoons and a record, and my signature would be taken when I will procure it from the kitchen stewarding department. The other opportunities are exploring effective method of carrying out various tasks of the kitchen stewarding department, maintaining washing machines, burnishing machine, and other equipment which is mechanically used in the kitchen stewarding department, pest control, which I told you earlier also, garbage disposal as per the local body's governing norms. The garbage disposal takes place, which will talk about the different types of garbage and how and different color coding that is there for that. Now the responsibility of the steward, the people, those who are on the soft floor of the kitchen stewarding, they engage in scullery, where was garbage disposable, kitchen cleaning, pest control, and cafeteria cleaning. This is what I have told you. Now the pot wash is either they do it manually or by the dishwashers. In case the pot is very big inside, then spray jet is being used and it cannot go inside the dishwasher, so they do it manually. Now wear wash and maintenance of silver room is handled by the kitchen stewarding department. Now generally when you talk about the dishwasher which is being located for in-room dining, kitchen, main kitchen, and for the coffee shop, generally in the back area dishwasher is being located from where all the cutlery, crockery are being cleaned either manually or electronically. For the banquet or for the fine dining restaurants, generally a satellite dishwashers are being created so that they can be handled there. It doesn't go to the one single common place for the dishwasher. Now garbage disposable, cleaning, and pest control, which I told you. Now green color garbage disposable is for renewable and recyclable materials, yellow is for non-renewable and recyclable materials, and red is for non-recyclable and non-reusable renewable products. So these are the three different codes of dustbins or garbage disposal that is being used in the hotel industry. Cafeteria cleaning, it is a responsibility of the kitchen stewarding department, and cleaning agents are being used to sanitize and make it hygienic for food preparation and food service. Now there are three different types of machine used in the kitchen stewarding departments. We call it dishwashers. The first one is known as glass washer. This is primarily used in the bar, because when you have frequent order of the guest, or suppose one guest only, so we don't serve in that same glass the cocktails. So every time when a guest order for a cocktail, a fresh glass needs to be used. So we have very frequently glass need to be cleaned, so it is being cleaned in that glass washers. Now the process is that the glass washes in the water rinse soap solution, and finally hot water rinse wiping it is required. In many of the machine they wipe it also and give it to you. Second one is known as single rack dishwashers. This type of rack or system is used in cutlery or for the crockery. It is a box type machine and a cover of sorts which can be pulled down or down to stop or start the machine respectively. The third one is known as conveyor belt type dishwashers. This is a dishwasher now used all around in the 5-star hotels. Now there is a conveyor belt and all the cutlery and crockery is lined in the racks. Now dividing, there is a curtain, there is a plastic curtain in between or a strip curtain in between which basically divide the area into manually and electronically, and chemical agents and heat are present out there to sanitize and clean the equipments. Now in this process the soiled equipments in the form of cutlery, crockery, glassware are loaded from one side and it cleans inside, and from the other side you get the clean and sanitized equipment which need to be further wiped. Now the three different types of dishwashers used are spray types. Okay, now it says These are neatly stacked in racks which slides into the machine which I told you earlier. The 48 to 60 degree centigrade is there. Okay. Now the racks then moved into sterilized section where the dishes are subjected to hot water shower at around 82 degree centigrade. The dishes sterilized at this time quickly dries up when it passes through the third drum, that is of the air. Second type is known as brush type. The dishes are scrubbed in hot detergent between 48 to 60 degrees centigrade with revolving brushes in between the dishwasher. Rinsed, sterilized, and from the other side you get the clean equipment. Third is known as agitator type machine. So it takes a little bit in between inside the drums. Okay. Now in this method what happens, basket of dishes are immersed in deep tanks and cleaned by mechanical by the former agitation where hot detergent water is being present. Now once it is being cleaned by the detergent, a final touch is being given by the hot water rinse for sanitization, which is around 82 degrees centigrade. Now these machines are manually operated by two people, one for sorting soiled items to feed the machine and the other to collect the clean ware. Now generally in the hotel we use the burnishing machine. It's a large drum which has got a ball bearing, and in between there is a rod in which you can, the glasses with the handles or cup with the handles are being placed on that rod, and the cutlery is put into the drum. Now the soap is added to the to avoid the friction of the ball bearings so that the scratches are not there to the equipment. Now the machine is either attached to the hot water or else water is poured manually. Now this kind of machine takes around 15 minutes for polishing the equipments. Silver plating machine is a separate room which I told you earlier, where EPNS cutleries and crockeries are being polished frequently. In case any cutlery or crockery which is EPNS, that is electroplated nickel silver, it is being polished with the silver coating, which is done in a separate room. Now the different types of record that is being maintained in the kitchen stewarding departments are logbook, duty roster chart, food and beverage inventory register, kitchen equipment register, dead stocks, scrap register. It means suppose any equipments are not in a proper state to function or there is a breakage. So a record is being maintained for that. Another is breakage and condemn registers are being maintained, LPG fuel consumption registers are being maintained. Machine report register is being maintained because machines are periodically cleaned and maintained, so that equipment is being maintained. Annual maintenance record of all the equipments are also being maintained. These are few of the record that is being maintained at the kitchen stewarding department. This is what we have discussed. The rest thing that is being record maintained is requisition form, pest control record, fumigation records are being maintained, temperature records are being maintained. Now few of the inventory that is being done by the kitchen stewarding department are, that is of kitchen area, because as I told you, kitchen equipments are a part of the kitchen stewarding jurisdiction. So all the equipments comes under jurisdiction of kitchen stewarding. So it need to be cleaned. It need to be inventory need to be done, which is done periodically either in 15 days or in a month. The waste management inventory need to be done so that revenue which could be generated through the waste are being at optimum level. And the restaurant inventory is being done periodically so that the kitchen steward has a tap regarding the cutlery which is being issued or the crockery that is being issued to the restaurant or to the F&B department. This is what we have planned for today. Any question that you have, feel free to ask me. Thank you. Looking forward to meet you once again in the coming class.